In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the abdominal aorta gross anatomy. The abdominal aorta is the main blood vessel of the abdominal cavity that transmits oxygenated blood from the thoracic cavity to the organs within the abdomen and to the lower limbs. So now let us begin this lecture with the origin of the abdominal aorta. So as you can see in this picture, the origin of the abdominal aorta is anterior to the lower border of T12 vertebra. As you can see here, the continuation, for example, this dotted line is the thoracic aorta and this is the aortic hiatus. From the aortic hiatus of the diaphragm, the abdominal aorta continues downwards towards the abdominal cavity. So the origin is at the T12 vertebra. So what is the course of this abdominal aorta? It descends through the abdomen, that is anterior to the vertebral bodies, because posteriorly we have the vertebral bodies and anteriorly what you can see the abdominal aorta, and ends at the level of L4. At the vertebral level called as L4, the abdominal aorta is terminated. So these are the terminal branches of the abdominal aorta. So what are the terminal branches? Common iliac arteries, right? So these common iliac arteries are the terminal branches of the abdominal aorta, right? So this particular bifurcation can be visualized on the anterior abdominal wall as a point approximately 2.5 centimeters below the umbilicus. So for example, if you take umbilicus at this level, so 2.5 centimeters below the umbilicus, exactly you can see the bifurcation of the abdominal aorta into two common iliac arteries. Or you can also say, for example, if these are the iliac crest on either side, the highest point of the iliac crest, the highest point of the iliac crest will be the level of bifurcation. So approximately 2.5 centimeters below the umbilicus, or a line extending between the highest points of the iliac crest, where we can exactly tell the point where the abdominal aorta divides into two common iliac arteries. So two important MCQ points over here: the origin is T12 and the termination is at the level of L4, right? So as the abdominal aorta passes through the posterior abdominal region, you can see on the other image, right, the prevertebral plexus of nerves and ganglia covers the anterior surface. Now, let us discuss about the branches of the abdominal aorta. First, let me talk about unpaid branches, because these abdominal aorta has paid branches as well as unpaid branches. In the unpaid branches, first let me talk about the celiac artery, which is also called as the celiac trunk. So this is called as celiac trunk. This is the celiac trunk, or we can also call it as the celiac artery. So this celiac trunk is the anterior branch of the aorta or the lateral branch? As you can see in this picture very clearly, that the celiac trunk is arising from anterior aspect of the abdominal aorta and it is unpaid. That is the reason we can say that the celiac trunk or the celiac artery is the anterior and unpaid branch of the abdominal aorta, where the origin is reflected to that of the upper part of the vertebra L1. So I will write this origin over here. It is upper part of the L1 vertebra. Important MCQ question, and upper part of the vertebra L1. Remember that upper part of the vertebra L1 is the origin of the celiac trunk. Immediately once the celiac trunk arises from the anterior aspect of the abdominal aorta, it immediately divides into the branches called as left, this one, left gastric artery, and one of the largest branch of the celiac trunk, which is called as the splenic artery. The splenic artery, which supplies important blood supply to the spleen, and this is called as common hepatic artery. As you can see, this is the common hepatic artery. So what are the three branches which are arising from the celiac trunk? Left gastric artery, splenic artery, as well as the common hepatic artery. So this is about the celiac trunk. Now let us discuss about another important branch. This one is called as the common, this is called as the superior mesenteric artery. So the superior mesenteric artery arises from anterior aspect to the lower part of the vertebra L1. So origin of the superior mesenteric artery can be reflected as L1 vertebrae only, but lower part. Upper part of the vertebra L1 is related to origin of celiac trunk. Lower part of the vertebra L1 is related to the origin of superior mesenteric artery, right? So it is related to, what is this? It is superior mesenteric artery. And another important point is, unpaid branch arising from the anterior aspect of the abdominal aorta is the inferior mesenteric artery. So this inferior mesenteric artery origin can be represented as anterior to the body of the L3. So this is inferior mesenteric artery. L3 vertebra, anterior to the L3 vertebra is the origin. Upper part of the vertebral body L1, celiac trunk. Lower part of the vertebral body L1, superior mesenteric artery. L3 vertebra, inferior mesenteric artery. And another important unpaid branch, what you can see over here, is called as the median sacral artery. So till now I discussed about 4 unpaid branches. Let me repeat once again: celiac trunk, superior mesenteric artery, inferior mesenteric artery, as well as median sacral artery. These are the 4, we can say, unpaid branches which are arising from the abdominal aorta. Next, let me discuss about the paired branches. The first one, as you can see here, this is the middle adrenal arteries. Next is the renal arteries. Renal arteries origin can be represented as between the vertebral bodies L1 to L2. So between the vertebral bodies of L1 to L2, we can say that the origin of the renal arteries. So this is an important MCQ point. So L1, L2, we can represent as renal arteries. Origin of the renal arteries. Next one will be gonadal arteries. We can say testicular arteries or ovarian arteries. The origin is between the vertebral bodies L2 and L3. Between L2 and L3, we can say that the origin of the gonadal arteries. We can also call it as the ovarian arteries or testicular arteries. And other important paired branches are inferior phrenic arteries. This is the inferior phrenic artery, this one. We have 2 inferior phrenic arteries over here, right? These inferior phrenic arteries supplies the inferior surface of the diaphragm. And we can see lumbar arteries. Actually, there are like 4 pairs of lumbar arteries over here. So there are 4 lumbar arteries on either side. So 4 pairs of lumbar arteries. These are the paired branches, we can say. So this is what is about unpaired branches as well as paired branches of the abdominal aorta. Now let us discuss about what are the visceral branches. In the paired as well as unpaired only, we have to discuss separately about the visceral branches as well as non-visceral branches. So whenever we discuss about the visceral branches, these branches either unpaired or paired vessels. So there are totally 3 unpaired visceral branches that arise from anterior surface of the abdominal aorta. What are they? We can see. First is the celiac trunk. Remember that the celiac trunk supplies all the structures related to the abdominal foregut. you can see the list over here, all the structures which are related to the abdominal foregut. Because the foregut begins with the abdominal esophagus, from the abdominal part of the esophagus, and ends just inferior to the major duodenal papilla, right? So from the abdominal part of the esophagus to the level of the major duodenal papilla, we can say that it is related to the abdominal foregut, right? So what are the structures which includes this abdominal foregut? It includes abdominal part of the esophagus, stomach, duodenum, that is superior to the major duodenal papilla, liver, pancreas, gallbladder, all these are related to the abdominal foregut and supplied by the celiac trunk. Not only that, spleen also. The spleen also develops in relation to the foregut region. That's the reason spleen is also supplied by the splenic artery, which is the branch of celiac trunk. So one important point we need to say that foregut structures are supplied by the celiac trunk. And next one is the superior mesenteric artery. Superior mesenteric artery, as well as its branches, supplies the structures of the abdominal midgut. So where the foregut ends, that is the anatomical location where the midgut begins. So the midgut begins just inferior to the major duodenal papilla, because up to the major duodenal papilla, we are calling it as abdominal foregut. Just inferior to the major duodenal papilla, where you can see the beginning of the midgut structures. So the descending part of the duodenum below the level of the major duodenal papilla, as well as ends at the junction between the proximal 2/3 and distal 1/3 of the transverse colon. This is the structures. These are the structures which are related to midgut. So these structures include duodenum, that is inferior to the major duodenal papilla, jejunum, ileum, cecum, appendix, ascending colon, and right 2/3 of the transverse colon related to midgut structure. So we can say that the superior mesenteric artery supplies all the structures of the midguts. And also we can say that the midgut is completely supplied by the superior mesenteric artery and its branches. And the next one is the inferior mesenteric artery. So foregut, celiac trunk, midgut, superior mesenteric artery. So hindgut is the inferior mesenteric artery. So inferior mesenteric artery supplies the abdominal hindgut. So this is what we need to know. So the paired visceral branches of the abdominal aorta we need to discuss right now, because unpaired visceral branches we discuss. So what are the paired visceral branches of the abdominal aorta? The first one will be the middle suprarenal arteries. As you can see, there are two middle suprarenal arteries on either side. So the middle suprarenal arteries are small, and these are the lateral branches. These are not the anterior branches, right? Lateral branches of the abdominal aorta arising just above the renal arteries, right? These are the renal arteries. Just above the renal arteries, you can see middle suprarenal arteries. Middle suprarenal arteries. So these middle suprarenal arteries are a part of the multiple vascular supply to the suprarenal gland. Because the suprarenal gland is totally supplied by three arteries: superior suprarenal, middle suprarenal, and inferior suprarenal. Superior suprarenal artery is a branch of inferior splenic artery. Middle suprarenal artery is a direct branch of the abdominal aorta. And the inferior suprarenal artery is a branch of the renal artery. So like this, it has like multiple arterial supply from multiple branches. And next is the visceral paired branches, that is renal arteries. The renal arteries are the lateral branches of the abdominal aorta that arise just inferior to the origin of the superior mesenteric artery, right? So this is the origin of the superior mesenteric artery. This renal arteries are arising just below the origin of the superior mesenteric artery, and the origin can be reflected as when related to the vertebral level between L1 as well as L2, and these arteries supply the kidneys. And next important are testicular or ovarian arteries. So these are not the lateral branches, right? So these are, we can say that gonadal arteries, which are also called as testicular or ovarian arteries. So these are the anterior branches of the abdominal aorta that arise below the origin of the renal arteries and passes downwards laterally to supply the related structures. So now let us discuss about the posterior branches of the abdominal aorta. So the posterior branch of the abdominal aorta or the vessels supplies the diaphragm or the posterior abdominal wall and also to the spinal cord. They consist of inferior phrenic arteries, lumbar arteries, there are four pairs of lumbar arteries, as well as median sacral artery, right? So now let us discuss about inferior phrenic arteries over here. So these inferior phrenic arteries arise immediately inferior to the aortic hiatus, right? And it mainly supplies the inferior surface of the diaphragm. So sometimes what happens is these inferior phrenic artery may arise from the celiac trunk or maybe directly from the abdominal aorta or as a common trunk from the abdominal aorta or from the celiac trunk. So whatever may be the origin, remember that the inferior phrenic arteries are the one which supplies inferior surface of the diaphragm. And next one is about the lumbar arteries. There are usually four pairs of lumbar arteries, what we can see, arising from the posterior surface of the abdominal aorta, and these lumbar arteries supplies the posterior abdominal wall and also it gives off segmental branches that supplies the spinal cord, right? So lumbar arteries are totally four pairs. They arise from the posterior surface of the abdominal aorta. They supply posterior abdominal wall and also it gives off segmental branches. These segmental branches supplies spinal cord. And the next one is the median sacral artery. So this median sacral artery is considered to be the final posterior branch of the abdominal aorta. So the final posterior branch is called as median sacral artery. This is the MCQ question. So this particular vessel arises from the posterior surface of the abdominal aorta just superior to the bifurcation, or we can say this area, right? You can see the dotted line. So just superior to the bifurcation and passes in an inferior direction, first over the anterior surface of the lower lumbar vertebrae and then over the anterior surface of the sacrum and coccyx to supply those particular structures. So this is what is about the abdominal aorta as well as its various branches.